me tell you about Ahab the Arab, the Sheik of the burning sand. He had emeralds and rubies just dripping off of him, had a ring on every finger of his hand. He wore a big old turban wrapped around his head, scimitar by his side. And every evening about midnight he'd jump on his camel named Clyde and ride silently through the night to the Sultan's tent, where he'd secretly meet with Fatima of the Seven Veils, swinging his grade A number one U.S. Joyce government inspected dancer in the Sultan's whole harem, 'cause him and her had a thing going. Yeah, and they'd been carrying on for some time now behind the Sultan's back, and you could hear him talk to his camel as he rode out across the dunes. His voice would cut through the still night desert air, and he'd say, which is Aramaic for whoa, baby. And Clyde say, well, he brought that camel to a screeching halt in the rear of Fatima's tent. Jumped off Clyde, snuck around the corner, into the tent he went. There he saw Fatima laying on a zebra skin rug, with rings on her fingers and bells on her toes and a bone in her nose, ho ho. There she was, friends, lying there in all her radiant beauty, eating on a raisin, grape, apricot, pomegranate, bowl of chitlins, two bananas, three candy bars, sipping on an ice cold Coca-Cola, listening to her transistor and singing, does your chewing gum lose its flavor? Ahab walked up to her, looked down into her eyes, and tenderly he said, hi, hi, baby, hi, baby, which is Aramaic for, let's twist again like we did last summer, baby. Ha, 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 ha. She looked up at him off the rug, flapped them big old eyelashes, and she said, all of a sudden, the Sultan walked in. Ahab knew that this was the end. Him and Fatima were caught by surprise, and the Sultan had fire flashing out of his eyes. Well, the Sultan charged at Ahab, intending to make a dent in his head. But he fled with Fatima, and out of the tent they went. They jumped on Clyde, started to ride, cutting out across the sand, with the Sultan's whole army in hot pursuit. On and on they ran. Well, to make a long story short, they got away, 'cause there wasn't no animal alive what could keep up with Clyde once he got started, 'cause he was the fastest steed on the whole desert, babies. Anyway, they made it across the border, where Ahab hocked all his rubies and emeralds and bought him a swinging little split-level pad, and they lived happily ever after. And that's the story about Ahab the Arab, Sheik of the burning sand. Ahab the Arab, the Sheik of the burning sand.